Hello and welcome to the YouTube edition playlist for the Django DRF project eCommerce. This course can be accessed here on YouTube. You can watch it here for free. The link to the YouTube course playlist is in the video description. You can also access this course on Udemy, where you can watch the course ad-free, download the tutorial source code, and access all updated tutorials and playlist. The link to the course, which should always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. So let me give you some information about the content of this course. This course isn't about getting to the end. This course is about the journey. So this first phase really tries to provide you the underpinning skills, working with Django DRF, working with a more complex database schema, testing your application and documenting your API. The database is core to any application. Here in this project, we will implement our database. And throughout this project, we will try to add complexity, iterating over the database, making changes, and then seeing how that then reflects within our application. Core to this project will be implementing endpoints so that clients can interact with our RESTful API. So here we're going to learn how to implement routers, viewsets, and serializers to create these API endpoints for client interactions. Now, I've tried to add some complexity into that by creating custom fields, by thinking about some other deeper customizations that you might want to make in an actual application. In addition to that, we will implement serializer customizations to customize data output. So this is going to be some very common types of activities that you're going to perform in order to customize and shape the data that's returned to the front-end client. This is also going to lead us down into the area of performance. So I've tried to include here some basic performance tutorials, whereby we look at the actual SQL code and think about how we can improve potentially the performance by reducing the amount of SQL queries that are actually generated. Once we start connecting serializers and using different tables and bringing different data into output, that's where we need to start thinking about performance potentially. So all of this work is underpinned by testing. So I've tried to go a little bit deeper here with testing, or at least try to test a little bit deeper than we would normally do. So here we're going to be building unit and end-to-end tests to ensure that the application works as intended. And then finally, documentation. So here in this course, we will be implementing or creating a schema utilizing SwaggerUI, and then utilizing the SwaggerUI interface to practice, test, and work with our endpoints. So this is a nice kind of automated process, which leaves us with an artifact that front-end developers then can utilize, determine what endpoints are available and how they can then interact with your endpoints. So if you do want to start to learn Django DRF in a really practical way, this kind of holistic approach to development, looking at design, implementation, testing, and documenting your application, I think is a really good starting point.